Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us to this Utilities Commission meeting for this January 10th, 2022, 6 o'clock p.m. We're going to open our meeting with a prayer. Commissioner Thompson, would you lead us in a word of prayer, please?
Dear Heavenly Father, we come here today, tonight, asking that you bless us. Bless us from all hurt, harm, and danger. Father, we ask that you speak through us and allow us to do and say the right thing for you, Father, for you. We ask that you bless our city, the sick, the shut-in, the bereaved families, everywhere. And we will be sure to give you all the praise and glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you so much. And you will stand and place the flag and
pledge
allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good evening, everyone. Call this meeting to order. Looking at our agenda, I need a approval of our agenda. I trust everyone had a chance to read over the agenda in the minutes.
I'll for motion that we approve the agenda as seen here.
Second. A motion is second. Second for approval of the agenda. Thank you. Next on the item, public comments. Any comments from the public? I'd like to recognize our distinguished guest, Councilwoman Bryant.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Good evening to everybody.
Thank you. Distinguished veteran, Ms. Easton. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. Good
thank you for your service to the country and our community. Next item, approval of the minutes. Public meeting of December 13, 2021. Need a motion? Approval of the minutes.
I'll for motion that we approve the minutes as read and stated here before us.
Have a motion before a second?
I second.
Motion second. All those in favor approving the minutes, by show of hands. Got the, all right, okay. Next item, Department Activity Overview, December of 2021, Financial Overview.
Good evening.
Good evening.
You should have a financial report that was on the table in front of you, separate from the main package. So I'm going to concentrate on the last four columns, the total, the budget, the variance, and the percent. And then as you'll notice to the far right, there's line numbers. So I'll reference those line numbers that will help you know what I'm talking about. So first, the total operating revenues, which is line three. We budgeted the total is 3.9, there's a variance of $87,000, which is 2%. Cost of goods sold, line number four. So we budgeted $1.9 million, we actually spent $2.4 million. The large percentage of that is gas, with a second being electric. The gas was $423,000 over budget to date because of the cost of fuel. We did make up with revenue on that, but we're still over about $200,000 for the gas charges. Which brings our gross margin, line number seven. We budgeted $1.7 million, and we're actually at $1.1 million. The next line is total expenses, line number 17. We budgeted to have spent $1.7 million. We spent $1.38 million. So our net changes in assets. budgeted to be in the black, $2,286. We're actually in the red, $347,000 as of November 30. Which when I look back into November of last year, we were around $200,000+ in the red in November of last year. Our electric will usually pick back up as you get to the summer months, and you'll see this start picking back up. So this is normal for this time of year. A little excessive because of the cost of gas.
When you say gas, you mean
natural gas. Yeah, the electric rates, the wholesale, got over 6 cents a kilowatt hour during the month of December. It's come down a little bit, but it's still above 5. So that really affects our margin. This is an unprecedented time because those gas costs have not just increased our gas wholesale, but also our electric wholesale. Any questions?
What is in other operating revenues and other costs?
So other operating revenue, that could be late fee, it's going to be connection fees. So let's say we had a customer and they needed a new water line. So you got a connection fee of $1,000, but it also could be an additional $5,000 to run the line to another area. One of them is a gas true-up, that was an agreement we have with Pure Flavor. But it's mainly going to be those construction costs. One-time fees, yes.
Include late fees?
It does include late fees, which is down, of course, because we just started charging those. Today was our first packet on late fees since the pandemic started.
And would other costs be other costs similar in nature?
So that particular item, like that was -$389.
Yeah.
That's actually for Roberta. So that's an expense line item. Uh-huh. But because we pay the city of Roberta $500 a month to collect payments on our behalf. Okay. And we charge the customers 1% administration fee. So what we collect goes into that revenue account and offsets the expense. So right now we're to the good $389, but you'll see that change as the year goes on, because as we're billing out gas towards Roberta, you get more of the 1%. But towards the summer month, you're not collecting as much from Roberta to offset that cost.
Well, what, I mean, just so I don't know.
No, that's fine.
So interesting, but I mean, there is, you know, a total of $300,000 in costs this month.
Under cost of goods sold, the other cost for the water plant and the wastewater plant is the cost to operate the plants. So the top line is purchase for resale.
Yeah.
So that's our wholesale gas cost and wholesale electric cost.
Sure.
Then the other cost, which is just under water and wastewater, water is the cost to run the water treatment plant, which is all expenses including personnel. And then the wastewater is the wastewater treatment plant.
Mm-hmm. Would it be asking too much if we could just see some of those charges, some of the one-time fees, you know?
That we collect and under.
That you collect, and because we don't know. You know, we don't know. I don't think we have to interrogate you to know these things. You know what I'm saying? If at all possible, you could come up with what they call it, something, some kind of sheet that you could just do it monthly. January, we collected $500 from Pure Flavor for this, or we collected a late fee for that. You know, you can just
summarize it.
Just give us a summary.
Because I went on a list of particular customers on what we collect from who.
Of course.
But I can try to summarize it.
Okay, that would be great.
Sorry for the financial, but any commentary on why the
of goods sold.
Yeah.
That being, what, $500,000. Above that, $108,000 was the electric, and $423,000 was gas. Now, also for other income, you'll see a negative $113,000. That was, I'm not sure, Clay, I think you talked about it last month.
Yes.
That was our investment. It was reevaluated due to some sales of bonds by MEAG, and it reduced our investment. And even though we haven't cashed in those investments, we have to record that as a loss, even though there's no actual money transpired.
Portfolio value.
So, but, sorry.
Is that what you're asking about, the negative 3.7?
No, I hear the 1.3. I mean, y'all are to the good, yeah. I mean, it's consolidated in our personnel purchase, you know.
It is, services. And, you know, it's year to date, so yeah. It's just really 2 months. But just because, so for the wastewater, let's say they budgeted $40,000 to do repairs to lines, distribution repairs. And so it's going to take the $40,000 and divide that into 12. But we may not
have needed it. Some of that may be more lumpy.
Right. Okay. Right. The only thing that's pretty regular that you expect to see is payroll. Because you can take that and divide it by 26 payrolls. Mm-hmm. But repairs and maintenance, you really can't. We do with uniforms because we know we purchase them twice a year. So we make sure we put those in the correct months.
Thank you.
Any questions you have, and if you think of something after me, feel free to get in touch with Blake or anything.
Well, part of it is I'm just getting more familiar with the line items.
I apologize to everybody that's been on the panel. I didn't think to start from the beginning and explain the sheet. Any questions y'all have, please let me know. I'll be glad to meet with you. Alright, I'll start with the activity report for December 2021. The Director of Finance. One thing we worked on for the month of December was preparing a plan for collection of arrears. The letter was drafted and half went out January 3rd, half went out January 4th. The audit has been scheduled for the week of February 7th, so I don't know that we'll meet again before they'll be here, but auditors will be on site that week. They may be here 2 weeks, but definitely will be here February 7th. And for the Synovus bond, we're no longer drawing from that bond since we're so close to getting the USDA grant closed. But to date, the commission has paid $737,462 towards the USDA project out of our funds. For customer service, they posted 5,012 payments. They initiated 380 service orders, 69 arrangements. And I did look up today, since today was the first time doing the late fees again, we did have 357 accounts with late fees for cycle one that generated today. And for the meter department, just on the last page of the activity report, they completed 407 work orders. They had 747 panel system reads and 100 water rebates. And for the new commissioners, I'll explain what the tantalus reads are and why we're looking for those. The tantalus meters are the new AMI meters that we can read from the office, and it's updated hourly, and we are still working on full deployment, which we hope to have done in March. But these are our pilot meters that are in the field, and we just keep track of how many reads we're getting in to make sure we're getting what we're expected and don't have any problems with. Questions on the activity reports?
further questions? Thank you, Ms. Kathy. All right, operations overview.
So we're on the activity report for the electric. We had one substation vent. We've had Willow Lake area, it was less than 5 minutes. Worked on 49 microwave orders. Been working on the security lights. We've repaired 4, installed 9. 5 disconnect reconnects. And responded to 44 locates. For the gas department, we did 113 locates. 22 work orders. We took 11 of the external corrosion control readings for cation protection and oxidative odorization readings on the checkpoints, also to verify the amount of stink in the gas. We completed our regulator station inspections. The water and wastewater, we repaired 4 service leaks, changed out 2 meters, worked on the emergency response plan, and participated in Sip and See Santa. Both the water, wastewater, and a few of the other employees also came out and met with the public. We pumped 46.428 million gallons of water. Then on the wastewater, we processed 38 locates. We pumped 800,000 gallons of sludge to the digester. And we sent 92,000 pounds of biosolids to landfill. Our monthly flow was 29.5 million gallons. Any questions on the operations?
Any questions for Ms. Clay? No questions? Thank you, sir. Public information, item C, senior citizens. Discount.
On the senior citizen discount, qualified, you must be 65 years of age, you have to reside at the location, and have the bill in your name. And then if you qualify for 5% off electric, gas, water, and wastewater.
This is a combination.
You have
5% or
all those together get 5% off, yes. We currently have 936 active accounts receiving the senior citizen discount. 936. That's why I'm reading it here right now, is to just to have more people know. And it is on the commission site also.
Okay.
So it's posted on Facebook. We have posted in the paper several times.
It's on the bills.
It's on the bills, yes, it's on the bills.
Right, probably most important.
It's on our doors. Yeah. It's on every public place that we can pretty much see.
And if we occurred every month at 5%?
Oh, that seems to be, yes.
Yeah. Any other questions about senior citizens discount?
Probably don't want up here with
it. I can't get it. All right, thank you. Next item, payment assistance.
Okay, the payment assistance is also advertised in all the same places. DFACS Peach County, you just call them at 478-825-6428. DFACS Crawford County is 478-836-6030. The Fort Valley CARES is administered through the DFACS. And the Neighborhood Service Center is 478-825-3193. and the Salvation Army is 478-922-2226. Below is set for the COVID relief was the Middle Georgia Community Action Agency at 1-800-525-4972. The Georgia Department of Community Affairs, Georgia Rental Assistance Program is at georgiarentalassistance.ga.gov. And the Volunteers of America is 478-919-2063. And this will all be broadcast on Facebook.
Okay, will you give me that last number again, please? That Georgia Rental Assistance. You have talked so good. Thank you.
Then I assume if somebody calls in, I know there's different programs and different contacts, but someone here could probably direct that person in the right direction. I mean,
that's right.
You know, hey, can I see if I need assistance or eligible for assistance? They can call in.
There are several of the assistants that don't actually have financial requirements.
I think I asked this question, or posed a question about letting the people know. And I know you all do Facebook, but you know how many people that don't do Facebook. I would like to know if we can at least put this information in the newspaper, in the Leaders Tribune. I asked this, I'm almost certain, 4 or 5 months ago.
We have put it in the paper, but we don't put it recurring in the paper.
Okay, we need to recur. Okay? Let's recur this because everybody don't get the paper. Everybody don't use the Facebook because I'm one of them. Okay? I don't go on Facebook. Y'all can call me whatever, but I don't go on Facebook that much. Okay? Or at all. So I feel that we need to publicize this, put it in the paper, you know, again.
Isn't that on the back of the bill?
It is on the back of the bill.
It is on the back of the bill?
Yes.
Okay.
The reason we don't put it in the paper every time is that it gets very expensive.
But it's on the bill every customer we have.
It is on the buildings, on all our doors. We put it out every option we get. A lot of different media. It's in the newsletters. You know, it's on web pages. But
okay.
Thank you so much. One of our distinguished guests would like to speak, Councilwoman Wright.
Senior citizens that I've already applied, but the last time we were here, we talked about that same situation, and y'all agreed to send the information to the different churches. Now that's a great way to get, and when there's information that the citizens need to have, especially the senior citizens, one of the greatest ways to get that information printed is through the church, because we have people that get a bill, they might not read. So that's not going to cover it. But if you would, as you said, this was the last time I was here, that you would get all these numbers and stuff sent to the churches so they can relay that information to the church members, and that would cover a lot of senior citizens. I feel like this COVID thing, because everybody's virtual now, but you know, word of mouth does a lot more than paying $10. They don't cost $100 to put it in the newspaper. But if you get to the churches, and the different organizations like public and different ones, then they can get it out to the community. And I would love to have a copy.
Yes, ma'am.
So that I can talk to the public.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much.
I think
everybody's responsibility, regardless, mm-hmm. it's our responsibility to reach one, teach one, help one.
Amen.
That's what we should be doing. They put us here. Bring it to them. That's where let's get the information. If I
Personally, I'll put the information forward as I can do it to all the churches I know. I think that's something that we all should be trying to do, is trying to make sure we have it in the right place. Thank you, Clay, for getting the information together. I need a copy of that so that I can move forward with that with the help from...
I'll get each one of you emailed a copy.
Thank you so
much. We'll get you all emailed a copy, and we'll get a list up for the churches.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Right. Any other discussion on that? I thank you, Councilman Bryant, for that, Clay, for bringing the information, all the comments on it. Let's each one of us try to do our very best to do what's right, do the right thing, look out for our seniors, and those of us that are rapidly approaching. Thank you so much on payment assistance. Moving on to, did you do the processing of the past due date, due payments?
Actually, they were just sent out, so none of them have been processed. Kathy specified there were 951.
Right.
Yeah,
991, and they were, half of them sent out on Monday, half of them sent out on the first day.
The third and the fourth.
The third and fourth.
We've had 20 payment arrangements made since the letters were sent out.
But since they just went out, there's really no activity.
Okay, thank you so much.
Did you put a date for them to respond?
They have until February 7th.
Okay, good.
All right, thank you. Update Friendship Circle?
Well, the project itself would be me, on the other would be Charles. The project's going along well. The tank's getting coated right now. 2 weeks and they should be done. They're just gearing out and they'll be ready for water. Everything else is moving along well. I know, did you want to talk to him about this? You want me to? We have an agreement, and the surveyors have surveyed the property, and they're just trying to get the plat recorded. As soon as they get it recorded, it can be deeded separately, and as soon as it's deeded separately, it can transfer.
Absolutely. And so, yeah, actually, yes. So I went ahead and recorded the plat. So the plat is recorded. Okay, so now we got to do background. I see the mayor is not aware of this.
See, my information was a day and a half old.
Water tower project on Friendship Circle, we had an issue. The USDA is funding it. We ran into an issue with ownership of that property. We've reached an agreement that resolves that issue so that now we're in a position to close on the bond financing of about $2.4 million. What we've had to do is actually purchase a piece of property from someone and hopefully on tomorrow, the tax assessor will assign a map and parcel number to the piece that we're purchasing, and that will be the end in terms of getting the property into the name of the Fort Valley Utility Commission. You've already authorized payment or authorized to negotiate a settlement, and we have done that. So I'm hopeful that we can get back on track with regard to scheduling the closing of the bond financing. I think part of what Ms. Johnson presented to you in your financial report, about $738,000 of your money, the utility commission's money that's out there paying for the project, because we haven't closed on the bond yet, but you get all that back when you close on the bond financing. And if you have, I know it's kind of short and quick, but if you have questions about it, I'll be happy to answer any questions that you have.
Questions? Thank you. Moving on to our next item, CCR.
I am ready to answer your question.
I only had just a couple of questions. So I was a little surprised to see the Consumer Conference report come to the House when it did. Was that a reprint of a previously distributed Consumer Conference report?
That was it had already been advertised and everything else. So yes.
Okay, and it's already gone into the state?
Oh yeah, it's all been done, yes.
Okay, when I saw that, I just had some questions about that. And then, looked like there was some missed samples. Did we miss a back key or a repeat?
We did not turn in the back fee information. So
it's the process you have to ensure that that doesn't happen.
It should have never happened.
Of course.
And we have another set of eyes looking at it every month to make sure. What happened is our main water operator retired. The class one that was doing the paperwork. And we had to switch over who was doing it. And it was less than 2 months later that our bacteriological samples, five of them did not get reported by the reporting date of the 10th. They got sent in on the 11th.
What is our CMMS system? Do we have Maximo, or do we have a CMMS system? Computerized maintenance management system. Maximo, Lucidy, something like that for work orders.
We have a work order system. Okay. It is a little bit cumbersome. It's used throughout the entire industry, not just our water department.
Okay.
And it goes, we're trying to get it cleaned up, because one of the problems with it is that when it gives out for a sample, it sends out 40 work orders. And so it's pages long, and most of them are repeats. And we've been working with them, but we haven't been able to correct the situation yet. So we're pretty much depending on ourselves to make sure the way the system is right now. Tests per shift.
Okay.
And we're three shifts a day. And then we do the specials. And then we do the ones that get sent in to match to make sure that we're accurate. So we're in the thousands.
Okay. That's fine. I just want to make sure on the CCR that was done was published properly and understand the missed back T's. Okay. Thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Any other questions? All right, old business is none. Moving on to new business.
I know we have no old business, but can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Something we discussed last month.
Sure.
We had the discussion and approval around the bonus payments. Do you have any commentary on how that would end up? I assume that was paid out the one time.
One-time bonus?
How it was paid out? It was paid out.
It was paid out. Yeah. The reception, there was a long discussion, so I was just curious if there was any feedback or commentary or if
the reception was very good.
Right.
It was extremely positive.
Good.
And yes, I personally received several emails in thanking people, and I also got a lot of individuals stopping by and thanking both the commissioners also for that.
It was just a long discussion. I'm just curious. I mean, I'm sure it was obviously received well. Obviously, but I'm just curious if you felt like it made the impact that you wanted it to have.
I did. I felt it made the impact very well.
If things have somewhat improved since
then. We've had several improvements.
Good.
We still have a long way to go.
Sure. Thank you.
All right, thank you. New business, item A, election of officers. I said officers of election.
So I guess election of
commission officers.
Election of officers.
Yes.
No problem.
Okay. The last, going on 2 years, Commission had a pretty rough go of it, just like everybody else in town and every other business and every other political group. And I'd like to say that Al has done, I think, a superb job through all of this. There's been a lot of conflict. Legally, we've been in a mess, and that's all been straightened out. I think Al has done a good job of keeping our
think we're making a motion, but since he was, Chairman Corbett is the subject of the motion, so we relinquish the chair to the, who's the vice chair?
The vice guy.
Oh, the other. You relinquish the chair to someone. So, Mr. Lindsey, would you assume the chair for the purpose of presiding over this? His motion concerns electing you.
All the time.
Okay, so we'd ask Mr. Lindsey to step in and just handle the procedural part of the motion.
Now, for that.
Okay. So there's a motion. Do we have a second?
Motion, second.
I second that.
All in favor, can I get a show of hands?
Unanimous vote. And again, now you can assume the chair and handle the other.
Oh, congratulations, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, sir.
Congratulations.
So with that, I'm just a little bit not knowing. So what Mr. Watson suggested that he assume his leadership or chairmanship duties, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So after that, we are supposed to second it, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So after this is seconded, we're supposed to vote on it.
Did we
second it?
Yes,
you
second.
Oh, okay.
Darrell second.
Darrell second. And then you call for the vote, correct?
Yes, ma'am. Can we talk?
Okay, next we got a new vice chair. I need nomination for a vice chair.
I make a motion simply just observing and saying that Commissioner Thompson is very up to par as far as we want to go in the right direction. And of course, going back to what you said last week, we want to move forward and doing the right thing. So I would make a motion that she back me up as the vice chair.
Have a motion on the floor for Commissioner Thompson as vice chair. Looking for a second.
I second.
Second by Commissioner Lindsey. All those in favor for Commissioner Thompson, vice chair, by show of hands.
Can I have a question before you vote? I think, you're the secretary.
She's secretary.
Or did she hold both jobs?
We have to do secretary as well.
Okay.
She cannot hold both jobs. you can decline.
No, it's just that I just like to say I don't know who nominated me to be secretary. I don't.
Marvin Crafter did when we did those back in when he came with the phone.
Oh, he did?
Yes, ma'am.
Was I there?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, I didn't hear it. Okay. Well, then, okay.
Mr. Kietrich, nominated.
Marvin, secretary, back whenever we did those, nominated him for secretary.
Okay.
Commissioner Jones nominated you for vice chair.
I heard that. Mm-hmm. Okay. I just didn't know about the secretary. I know I signed documents, but I did it because Attorney Jones told me to. I'm signing, but I don't remember. Okay.
So we have a motion, a second.
Motion, second. The discussion. You said she's secretary. She can decline if she wants to remain the secretary. Is that correct? correct?
That's correct. And she would have to accept it.
Right.
She wanted the position. So you've been nominated for.
Vice chair.
And the question is whether you want to remain, whether you would rather remain as secretary, at least be considered for secretary.
Yes, I'll be vice chair, but I don't think I want to be both.
No, ma'am, you can take it both.
Okay, that's what I'm saying.
We did do both, right? Got the vote. Second. All those in favor, Commissioner Thompson, vice chair for Valley Utilities Commission, by show of hands. Any opposed? Same sign. Thank you. Position of secretary. Nomination for someone to be secretary of the Utility Commission.
I'd like to offer a motion that we nominate Mr. Commissioner Dickey as secretary.
Motion Commissioner Dickey as secretary for a second.
I second that.
Second. Any discussion? All those in favor? All those in favor of Commissioner Dickey, the Secretary of the Utilities Commission for the ballot, by show of hands. Unanimous? Any other discussion? Moving on to our next item, item B, bylaws.
The bylaws were suspended on October 12th, 2020, and we've been operating without any bylaws. And we are suggesting that you consider reinstating.
Just for somebody new on the board, could we get just quick background and why they were suspended, what has happened during the suspension, and what that impact does?
Oh, everybody's looking at me, but I'm not
the rule book we play by.
Sure.
They specify exactly how things should be done. And in order to amend them or change them or anything else, the first thing you have to do is reinstate them so they could be amended if you thought there was a problem or something with them. But as of right now, we're operating without them, which it kind of makes you operating without any sort of policy, which is not a good idea.
Yeah. Well, why were they suspended? Why were they suspended?
They were suspended simply because Commissioner, Lord bless his soul, Marvin Crafter, thought that those bylaws were catered mainly to the GM. Mm. Okay? So after going over those bylaws, he felt that, hey, why are we catering to the GM? And that's exactly what's going to happen right now. We as commissioners are not going to have anything to say. If we bring in those bylaws, we don't even need to be here. If we're going to have those bylaws, we as commissioners need to look over them. We're not going to just get those bylaws. We're just not going to get the bylaws and just let them bring them to us. We need to be part of those bylaws. We need to be a part of it. We don't need you all just to bring us those bylaws and say, okay, this is what we're going to do. We need to look at those bylaws and go over them. We need to do that. And right now, I don't think that we should consider those bylaws until every commissioner have gone over those bylaws.
Okay, so I'll tell you the little that I do know. I know I was not part of that whole process. But I can tell you that as an organization, you need operating policies and procedures. I'm not sure that you have them other than your human resources and your personnel policies. I don't know that you have operating policies and procedures that are written other than the bylaws that you have. I think that's the purpose, that was the purpose of the bylaws. If you were a true municipality, then you'd have a charter, you would have a code of ordinances that you could adopt and amend, but you don't, because you're not a municipality in the sense of being a county government or a city government. So you do need some, I don't know what's in those bylaws, but I do know that they only can be effective if you approve them. So if there's something in the bylaws that you don't like or something you want to add, you have the full authority to determine what's there and what's not there. I would just encourage you to have something that is in place that provides guidance to your staff as to how they ought to be operating.
We have a personnel policy, and we have a financial, a really in-depth financial overview of everything we do financially. I thought that bylaws were generally not for municipal environments, they were more corporate set of circumstances. Before the bylaws came from, I wasn't here either then. I don't know who developed them, where they came from, but we never here before had bylaws. We had operating procedures, we had personnel policies, we had financial overview, which with the combination of all three of those, I think covered every act that the utility commission was going to have, and how we did all of our business with those three things. I don't know how in-depth the bylaws are, what they cover. When I came back here temporarily in November, they had already been suspended, so I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know
anything about the bylaws, what issues they address, and what they say, and what they're in conflict with personnel policy, or they're in conflict with financial overview. But to Rose's point, I think we need to look at them. The hotel manager and staff need to go through them pretty good and make sure they mirror what we do.
Of course.
And then adopt them. Or
yep.
They don't mirror what we do, then don't adopt them and make, you know, I still don't think bylaws are appropriate for municipal government.
Yeah, and I agree with you. Except to the extent that you need to have something that yeah. talks about how you operate as a corporation.
Exactly.
And like I said, I don't know what's there, but it's certainly worth looking at.
I guess that may also expose us to other risk.
Mm-hmm. So you may review them, decide you don't. But I guess the main point I would make is they are only effective if you approve them. They're yours. They're not your staff. You get to decide what goes there, if anything.
I think it would be appropriate for the staff first to go through and see what they say versus what we do and let them make suggestions and then make it, then give it to the commissioners and let the commissioners go through it. But the staff is the group that holds the knowledge of what's going on and how we conduct our business. And what we're doing don't even match the bylaws at all, and it's just so I agree with Rose. I think my suggestion would be for the staff to go through the bylaws and strike those things that are clearly outside of the bounds of good business practice or bad things that are essential for good business practices and submit that draft to the utility commission.
Okay, what we're saying is we're going to table this bylaws for right now. Am I hearing that correct? And we're going to get our senior staff to go over the bylaws, get together on what the bylaws are and where they need to be improved, get with the commissioners the findings of those, so we'll know what to add, to strike away, once we reinstate those bylaws, we'll know what to do rather than just have them in play. Am I understanding?
I would like to request a copy for the board of the current, because I want to know what they suspended.
Right.
Just out of sheer curiosity.
I can say one thing that we suspended them was because the bylaws I had in there, he could spend $50,000 to drop it down, and then he'd come back and inform us, hey, I spent $50,000 on this project here.
Yes.
You know, we thought that was kind of out of line, that he should have come to us. And we discussed if we were going to spend that much money or not.
So one of it was suspended.
And those things was the previous lawyer we had at council. Advised us those bylaws were illegal because we operate under the city's charter. With the city having a charter, their own bylaws, well, she said we were operating under their charter. So we could not have bylaws, we had to operate under the city's bylaws because we were operating under the city's charter. That's what the previous lawyer that advised us, and we made that move to suspend the previous bylaws.
Well, not because we don't know bylaws came about, a lot of discussion about the bylaws and the implementation of the bylaws, I believe, came into being because of a conflict between the vice chairman at the time and the general manager at the time. That's what germinated all this issue about developing bylaws, because the vice chairman thought that the manager had way too much authority financially as otherwise. He was out operating almost independently from the utility commission. I'm not saying he was or he wasn't. That was the idea that the vice chairman had at the time.
Yeah, and that's one for the folks who were kind of new here. I understand there was some question about the relationship between the city and the utility commission, but that's been resolved. About litigation and through the passage of legislation, there's no question as to whether the utility commission is a standalone entity. It is a standalone entity, separate and apart from the city of Fort Valley.
Yeah.
So, but I understand how that was a question at a time, at one point in time, but it's not an issue anymore.
So, based on, I have the least understanding, but based on your understanding of the separation of the two entities, it would make sense to have our own set of bylaws.
I think it makes sense to have something that is incorporated, that you have approved, the commission has approved,
yeah.
In terms of that details how you're going to operate as a corporate entity.
Sure.
All right, so am I in understanding we're tabling the bylaws? Senior staff will look at the bylaws as to how they are and how they best work with our operation. And we also need for each commissioner to get a copy of the current bylaws as they were. So when and if the changes come about, we'll know what we're changing out with the old, in with the new. We'll know where we're changing from and what we're going to, if there needs to be a change, if they need to be reinstated. Am I understanding that to be correct?
That's right.
Two key terms, you said.
Okay. So that's table, bylaws are table. All right, moving on to the next item. Item C, Giga Derrick contract award.
Hello, Ben. The electric department got approval to get a new digger for Derrick. They went out for public bid and they received four bids. Right now, they are asking to award the bid to Terex Utilities. We had problems with Altec bid to Derrick at $238,000 without a delivery date, and they had a question on what year it was, the truck body that they were given, but there were just some problems. VersaLift Southeast was $260,000 with 400 days delivery. It was also under spec. Nesco was $290,000, which was over spec and over budget. and the Terex utility bid was $262,000 for the replacement of the truck, and they were the only bid that actually met the conditions that were requested with the style of the truck and also fit the budget. And so we are asking to go with the bid from Terex Utilities for the Digger Derrick truck.
What's their turnaround time?
I believe this is an on-hand truck. So
I think it's modified.
Yes. So we should be able to get it right away.
And how much was that?
That was $262,390.
Who was $238,000?
That was Alltech.
Alltech?
Yes.
And what you didn't like about Alltech?
Do you have the spec sheet there? When these went for a sealed bid, and they bid on these trucks, they bid on these two spec sheets. I don't know if they're in your packet.
Alltech says that they do not provide an estimated delivery date and the specifications of what you requested.
Yeah, I just didn't know if they had it. It was severely substandard for what we're looking for.
Okay.
Terex is a premier provider in the electrical industry, and they have a bid as to what we requested. I make a motion that we accept Terex bid and get it delivered as they did.
Have a motion on the floor, second?
Second.
Motion is second to accept the Terex bid, $262,319. All those in favor, by show of hands. Any opposed?
Thank you.
All right. Next item, Knoxville contract award.
Yeah, this one's a little easier. Both of these are operations manager was going to present them, and at the last minute there was guessing he ran out here. So that's how I got up here for these. We had reserved $105,000 for the project. Now this project was to relay some lines. This proposal makes it look like it was just for a couple customers. But this was recircuiting a line, and so it was actually for the whole area. And we had thought it might cost up to $105,000, but over and under bid it for $36,400. And out of our sealed bid, they were the only one that had a bid on it. And they were well within budget. It was approved for $105,842.37.
The bid was $36,400.
Yes, sir.
That's your recommendation, huh?
Recommendation that it be approved and given to over 100.
So moved.
Have a motion second?
Second.
All those in favor of moving forward with the approval of this contract?
Ask a question before we do that.
Discussion?
Are we sure that they understand the scope of this?
They do a lot of work for us. They know exactly what it is, yes.
Okay.
All those in favor, by show of hands, to approve this award to on the Knoxville Street Reconductor. All right. All right. Thank you. Next item. D.O. meters at the treatment plant.
Dissolved oxygen meters at the Lanter treatment plant. For the main aeration tanks that need to be replaced. We've had a rough estimate of $40,000. We had two bids come in and then one bid be withdrawn because they didn't want to use our wiring, which was going to the DO tanks. They wanted to replace all of it and make it much higher. And so when they left us with, we just had the one bid of $24,645. We had the $40,000 in capital for this improvement of the Ledger plant, and we're recommending that they be approved for capital to replace the VO markers.
Brand VO meter?
This is Corbin, I'm sorry, Corbin Services.
What brand is it?
Q-Class Auto Clean Assembly with the MES 4X IP66 enclosures and submersible auto clean sensors.
This is everything that we want and we need, right?
This, right now, our oxygen sensors are all worn out, but it's all oxygen sensors.
I'm not being picky, but do you know why you only got this one bid?
We contacted several people, and it's very difficult to get people. It was difficult to get people to come in and bid on it.
Okay, and we got budgeted $40,000, right?
That is correct.
We contacted at least 5 different services.
Do you have a warranty on these?
I can find out for you, but I'm going to assume it's a 1 year. Our last ones are much older.
All right, entertain a motion to that effect. Any other discussion before we move forward? No discussion? Entertain a motion to accept the award for the job to Corbin Services.
Motion to accept.
Got a motion? Second?
Second.
Motion is second. All in favor of the award for Corbin Services, show of hands. Unanimous. All right, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
That's it. Executive session.
Mr. Chair. Excuse me, sir.
Yes, sir.
Before the executive session, I just want to ask you a question. And I heard Mr. Jones say about city and the utilities and the utilities being a separate entity with the ruling that came down from the state. And just to say I get a better understanding and clarity of a lot of different things, but I just want to let it be known that we appreciate the city of Fort Valley, appreciate the assistance that go along when we're doing our budgeting from the Utilities Commission. I'm not sure what these changes might bring about, but I do know that since being involved with the city for over 27, 28 years, there was a money that came from the utilities that assisted with our budgeting. Things of that nature. So I just wanted to say that when we find out more and learn more, we still want that assistance from the Utilities Commission. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor London. Thank you, everybody. We plan on moving forward,
yes,
out with the old, in with the new, doing the right thing for our citizens, employees, all of us in the room. We're doing the right thing.
One more question. Want it to be that I'm voting and don't have a vote. So I'm raising my hand every time I vote because I want to make sure that if I'm just in observance, that's good. I will be bringing concerns also to the Utilities Commission, but I want to make sure I'm not just doing this and don't have anything with my hand go up. So, yeah.
We'll have our attorney brief you all the rules and the regulations that you do.
Thank you.
Thank you. We have a need for executive session?
I don't have anything, but I'd like to address the mayor. Welcome to Jones. To the commission. And I appreciate the comments that the mayor just made because from the very beginning, the whole reason for having the mayor as on the council, having that position as an ex officio position was so that the city could bring its concerns to the utility commission and take that information from the utility commission to the city so that you could work in tandem in terms of doing what you just said, which is doing what's in the best for the interest of the citizens of the city of Fort Valley. So that is, I appreciate your comments. I just wanted, even though the position, you vote only in case for a tie, you do serve a valuable, that position serves a very valuable service in terms of informing your council and bringing your concerns to the commission so that you can work together to make life better for the citizens of the city of Fort Valley and the ratepayers of the utility commission.
No need for executive session. I'd like to thank everyone for our new commissioners. Thank you for coming. Those of us that are returning, thank you for coming back to our newly elected Mayor Lundy. Thank you for attending. We look forward to doing the right thing. My distinguished guest is Issa, Commissioner Bryan. I said another place, I can't get the name.
Tanya Blackman.
Hey, Tanya Blackman, thank y'all for attending. Thank you for coming. Come next time and keep on coming, and we'll get something to eat later on. I thank everybody for attending this meeting today. This meeting is adjourned. Thank you.